Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
How are you today?
Very good.
So it is so happy to see you all. Thank you so much for coming. Before we start our meditation practice, I would like to share with you something. Today meditation, especially we want to bless Todd Nielsen. He is our office manager and long-term Sangha member, and Todd always help us, and he always come to the temple and he do a lot of things for the temple. So we really want to bless Todd and also Todd's aunt, and she's in a bad health condition right now, and her name Betty Bidstuff, and Todd want to bless her, and we are going to chant especially after meditation for Todd and Todd's aunt and also for all of you. So thank you so much for Todd for sponsoring this meditation session. We can think about Todd's aunt also during our loving kindness practice. We can send our beautiful thoughts to her. Be well, get well soon. Please think about that one too. We can start our meditation practice. Please sit quiet and comfortable posture. Keep your back straight as much as you can. Gently close your eyes. Take a few deep long breaths and relax your whole body. Breathe in softly and breathe out softly. It is very important to relax your mind and also your body. Spend a few minutes with your body. And see all part of your body individually and observe, are they relaxed? Now we are going to spend beautiful 30 minutes . Let's practice loving kindness meditation. Say to yourself, wish to yourself, and bless to yourself. Try to be loving and kind person to yourself. May I be well. May I be happy? May I be peaceful? May I be able to find noble friends? May I be strong and healthy mentally and physically? Understand the meaning of the each words deeply and clearly, then please do yourself. May I be well. May I be happy. May I be peaceful. Now imagine your loved ones, your family members, your friends, your husband or wife, girlfriend or boyfriend, your teachers. Imagine your all loved ones. Imagine their faces individually. All my family members, be well, be happy. Be peaceful. May not any difficulties come to them. May not any dangers come to them. May they be able to find noble friends. May they be strong and healthy, mentally and physically. May all my family members, free from mental and physical suffering, may they be free from anger, jealousy, hatred, difficulties, may they be free from all negative thoughts. Today we are going to send our loving and kind thoughts, especially Betty. She need our good wish. She need our beautiful blessings. In this moment, we are developing our loving thoughts. Those are very powerful. Please think of her. Her name is Betty. We can send our loving and compassionate thoughts to her. May she be well, happy, peaceful. May she be free from mental and physical suffering, illness. May not any dangers come to her. May all our blessings be with her. Now we can send our loving and kind thoughts towards to the living beings. Send our loving and kind thoughts without any discrimination. May all the living beings be well, be happy, be peaceful. May they be able to find peaceful, healthy, and comfortable environments. May they be able to take care of themselves happily. It is time to send loving and compassionate thoughts towards to your difficult one. If you have any difficult people in your life, imagine them. No need to get anger. Send loving and kind thoughts towards to them. May my difficult people be well, be happy, be peaceful. May they be able to find noble friends, good advice. May they be strong and healthy, mentally and physically. In this moment, we develop our loving thoughts. If you have practiced this loving kindness meditation, it means we are developing forgiveness practice. It means you are going to be a noble friend to yourself. You are going to be a noble friend to others. You are going to take care of yourself. You are going to take care of others. Try to develop your loving thoughts every day. Now we can practice mindfulness breathing meditation. Take a few deep long breaths and focus on your natural ordinary breath. Bring your attention to the tip of your nose. Take each breath mindfully. No need to control your breathing, just focus your natural, ordinary breath. Breathe in mindfully and breathe out mindfully. So many sounds, thoughts may distract you. Let them come and go. When you are breathing, you can see short breath in and out, long breath in and out. When you see short breath, observe I am taking short breath. When you see long breath, understand I am taking long breath. No need to think about your past memories or your future plans. Just enjoy this moment we call present moment. Where is your attention? Please come back to the breath. Now monks are going to do a special chanting, especially for Betty and especially for all of you. We are going to do Prarthana Sutta, it's mean a great blessing sutta. We are using Pali language. You can't understand what we are chanting. But 2600 years ago, Buddha used this chanting for blessings. Today we are going to use that same sutta. It has so much beautiful words. This chanting include beautiful energies. You can think your loved ones, you can imagine who need your blessings. Especially we want to send blessings for Betty. May not any difficulties come to her. May not any dangers come to her. Get well soon. Also, you can think of your loved ones. During the chanting time, you can practice loving kindness meditation. You can send these loving and kind thoughts towards to them. Please listen in this chant lovingly and kindly. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato. Bhagavān sammā sambuddho vijja charana sampann sugato lokavido anuntaro purisa dhamma sārati santā deva Buddho bhagavati svakkato bhagavata dhammo sandhintiko akaliko pansiko panayiko panchattang veditambo vinyo Supatipanno bhagavato savaka sangho Jupatipanno bhagavato sangho Nyaya patipanno bhagavato savaka sangho Yamichi patipanno bhagavato savaka sangho yadidam chantari purisa yugani atta esa bhagavato savaka sangho ahuneyo pahune dakkineyo anjali karaneyo anu Uttaram punyakin lokan sati etena sancha bandhe dukkha upasamintu te etena sancha vanjena bhaya etena sancha vajjena Jena roga upasamintu te Yāne dhūtāne samāgatāne bhummāne vāyāne vāntalīṃ sambheva bhūtā sumanā bhavantu atopi saṃ sunantu bhāsitāṃ tasmāi bhūtāne sāmetasaṃ mentaṃ karota manusiyā pajāya divācaranto tasmāhi nerankata ampamantāyaṃ kinci vinta idvāhuraṃ vāsagge suvāyaṃ ratanam nano samaṃ atti tathāgatena idāmpi bhunde ratanam etena saccena suvattiyotu kayaṃ virāgaṃ amataṃ pani yadajjagā sakya muni samāhito natena dham dhamme ratanam panitaṃ ete saccena suvattiyotu yam buddha setto parivannaye samādhimānantarikanyamāvu samādhināthena samūna idampi dhamme ratanam panitaṃ etena saccena suvatti ye puṅgalāṭṭha satampa santā cattāri etāni yugāni an te dakkhineyā sugatassa sāvakā etesu pilāni dampi saṅghe ratanam pani saccena suvattiyotu ye suppayun manasā dallena nikkhāmino gotama sāsa te pattipantā amataṃ vigayya laddhā mudā nimbutiṃ idāmpi saṅghe ratanam panitaṃ etena sacce suvattiyotu yatinda kīlo paṭavin sito chatu bhivāte bhi asampakampiyo tatupamansam purisaṃ yo ariya sacchāni avecca pansati dāmpi saṅghe ratanam sañcena suvattiyotu ye ariya sacchāni vibhāvayaṃ gambhīra paññena sudesitāni kinca honti busappamantā na te bhavaṃ aṭṭhamaṃ ādiyaṃ idampi saṅghe ratanam panitaṃ etena saccena suvattiyotu sahāvassa dāsana sampadāya tayasu ධම්මා ජහිතා භවන්ති සක්ඛාය දෙන්ති විචිකිච්ඡිතං සීලබ්බතං වාපි අදාති කිංචි චතුපා හිච්චවෙප්පමන්තෝ චචාභිතානානි අබම්බෝකාතුන් ඉදම්පි
සංගේරතනං පනීතං
ඒතේන සච්චේන සුවාත්තයෝතු කිංචාපි සෝකම් කරෝති පාපකං කායේන වාචා උදචේතසාවාබං පටිච්චාදාය අබබ්බතාදිච්ච පදස්සවුන් ඉදම්පි සංගේ රතනම් පනේතං ඒතේන සච්චේන සුවාත්ති වනප්පගුම්බේ අතාපුස්සිතංගේ ගෙම්මාන මාසේ පටමස්නෙන් තතුපමන්දම්ම වරං අදේසයි නිබ්බානගාමින් පරමං බුන්දේ රතනම් පනේතං ඒතේන සච්චේන සුවාත්ති වරෝ වරඤ්ඤෝ වරදෝ වරාහරෝ අනුත්තරෝ ධම්ම වරං ඉදම්පි බුන්දේ රතනම් පනේතං ඒතේන සච්චේන සුවාත්තයෝතු කේනම් නත්ති සම්භවං විරත් චිත්තායතිකේ බවස්මින්තේකේන අවිරුල් හිච්ඡන්දානිබ්බන්ති ධීරායතායම් පදීපෝයිදම්පි සං රතනම් පනේතං ඒතේන සංචේන සුවාත්තයෝතුයා භූතානි සමාගතානි බුම්මානි වායානිව අන්තලේ තථාගතං දේව මනුස්ස පූජිතං බුන්දං නමස්සාම සුවාත්ති භූතානි සමාගතානි බුම්මානි වායානිව අන්තලේ තථාගතං දේව මනුස්ස පූජිතං ධම්මං නමස්සාම සුවාත්ති යානේද භූතානි සමාගතානි බුම්මා තථාගතං දේව මනුස්ස පූජිතං සංඝං නමස්සාමි සුවාත්තයෝතු ඒතේන සච්ච වජ්ජේන දුක්ඛාවූප ඒතේන සච්ච වජ්ජේන භයාවූප සමෙන් ඒතේන සච්ච වජ්ජේන රෝගාවූප සමෙන් සම්බිතයෝ විවාජ්ජන්තු සබ්බ රෝගෝ විනාසතු මාතේ භවත්වන් සුඛේ දීඝායුකෝ භව භවතු සබ්බ මංගලං රක් पकान्तु सब देवता संबुद्धानुभावेन सदा सोत्ति भवन्तु ते भवतु सब मंगलं देवता संब धम्मानुभावेन सदा सोत्ति भवन्तु ते भवतु रक्खन्तु सब देवता संब संगानुभावेन सदा सोत्ति भवन्तु ते Now your mind and body are relaxed, peaceful and calm. Please bring your palms together in front of your heart. Make a strong determination to practice this meditation every day, at least 5-10 minutes. May peace be with you. May all the living beings be well, happy and peaceful. Thank you so much. Slowly open your eyes. Today I would like to share with you some short message about noble friends. I think we all need to have some special friends. We have many friends in our daily life. When you think about your childhood, you can imagine how many friends that you had. So now, I think you have so many different kind of friends. One time Buddha was talking about three ideas that we have to think every day. First one is Buddha said, we have to think about ourselves. We have to observe about our mind. We have to observe about ourselves. We have to think, who am I? It means you are going to focus your insight. That's the first one, you have to always think. The second one is Buddha said we have to focus on our thoughts. Think in just one moment, in just one second, thousand of thousand thoughts come to our mind, come and go. Then we have to observe, we have to discover about our thoughts. The last one is the important thing what Buddha said, we have to find someone specially to our life. Buddha said we have to find a special teacher. Or we have to find some noble friends to our daily life. It means if you find someone especially noble friends, that word has so much deep meaning. Noble friends, they are very special. So noble friends, they are always want to help us. They are always want to guide us. When you think about your life, maybe you can imagine so many noble friends. I was thinking our first noble friends are our parents. We call our first teachers. Also, they are our noble friends. As a parents, they are always guide us. They are always want to see our good. They want to lead us good way. They are always leading us. They are always advising us. So noble friends are very important. That's why Buddha said, if you can't find a noble friend, try to live alone. It means you are not going to engage with any kind of bad things. You are not going to engage with any kind of bad people. If you really hard to find a noble friend, try to live alone. So I think you all have different kind of friends. If you are start to come to this place, also you can find so many good friends, noble friends. We all monks are noble friends. This all the people are noble friends for you. because noble friends always want to guide you really well. Also, one time Buddha was talking about three kind of people. When you think about this world, there are so many kind of people. Also, you know, we all are called human. It has deep meaning. Among the human beings who can develop, phrase, cultivate their mind up to the maximum level, that's why we all are called human. It means we can develop our mind, we can cultivate our mind, we can raise our mind up to the maximum level. Practicing meditation, listening to some talks, or reading some books will help you to gain your wisdom. There are four kind of people that we can see in this society, in this world. They have four signs. What is the first one? Some people go to darkness to darkness. That's the first one, darkness to darkness. Second one we call, they go to darkness to light. Darkness to light. Third one, how about them? They go to light to darkness. Okay? The fourth one is, they go to light to light. Did you understand what is the meaning of these four people? Did you understand? Yeah, first one, they go to darkness to darkness. It means they are going to do again and again, over and over, over and over, something bad. The second one, they go to darkness to light. It means they are going to develop something good. Third one, they go to light to darkness. They know something good things, but they are not practicing, they are going to do something bad. I think you all are go to light to light. It means you know how valuable this life, you know how important this human life. It means you want to keep practice something special in your daily life. So you are go to light to light. But when you think about this everything, we have to have some really special good friends. We all call noble friends. There are four kind of noble friends that I am going to share with you this evening. Maybe you can see this kind of friends in your life. If you have this kind of friends, go to them and ask help. Usually noble friends are not nice. Why they are not nice? They always want to see you good. If you do something bad, what noble friends do? They come to and maybe they yelled at you. Maybe they want to, they are maybe sometimes using rough words. That's a noble friends. Because they want to guide you. They want to protect you. That's a sign of noble friends. There are four kind of noble friends. The first one called the protector or helper. In Pali language we call Upakaraka Mitta. Upakaraka means protector. He want to help you. Maybe when you think about your life, you can imagine that kind of friends who help you, who protect you, who want to protect from you everything, who want to protect your family, your child. That's the first friend. He's called protector. He's a special one. That's the first noble friend. The second one we call the enduring friend. We call in Pali language Samana Sukha Dukkha. We know sometimes in our life we have hard time. Sometimes we have very relaxed, easy and comfortable times. We can heard so many stories. If you have money, everyone come to you. If you have money, everyone come to you. But if you don't, what happen? Everyone just go away from you. There are so many stories. Maybe close friends, maybe your family, they just go away from you. But who's the second one? If you have money or not, they always come to you and help you. if you don't have anything, just come to you and support you. That's a second noble friend. He is never going to give up you. Try to find that second one. The third one called the mentor or advisor. He's the rough one. He's the tough one. The advisor. He's always want to guide you. Always want to give some good message. Try to find also third one. The fourth one we call the compassionate friend. He's very kind. He's very nice. When he going to tell something, want to explain something nicely and kindly. He don't want to hurt you, but in the same time he want to protect you. So those are the noble friends that you can find in your life. If you can find those noble friends, just live with them, because they are so important. That's why Buddha said, try to find someone special. Try to find noble friend. If you can find, live alone. So think about this for people. Try to understand how important noble friends. They can help you, they can guide you. So this friendship is very important. Think about this idea. Try to find someone really special to your daily life. So I think you learned something. Thank you so much for coming. Have a beautiful night. And also thank you so much, Todd, for your sponsoring this meditation session. And may you all have a beautiful night. Thank you.